Hello again, Grizzly football fans, and welcome back for a special bye week edition of Griz Tracks. I'm AJ Mazzolini with the Mazzoulian.
And I'm Bill Speltz. I cover the Grizz football team for the Mazzoulian.
And the bye week is coming at a very opportune time for the Grizzlies this year, right in the middle, as opposed to at the beginning or the end of the season, as it has been in recent years, because there are some guys with injuries that need that extra week off. Specifically, we're looking at the quarterback, Jordan Johnson, this week.
Definitely, AJ, and the players said as much yesterday that it couldn't have come at a better time. You think about the last few years, it came earlier in the season, and at one season it came way late. So this is perfect. They're six games in. They've got a handful of guys that really need the rest, and topping the list is Jordan Johnson, who won't be practicing this week. He'll rehab the ankle, and then they're going to make an evaluation on Tuesday of next week. It looks good, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see.
Yeah, and right, if you remember, Jordan Johnson injured that ankle early on in that win over North Dakota last week on a late hit. After the play, he got knocked around a little bit and didn't play any of that game, and they were still able to take the victory with Shea smithwick-hann taking over the helm and leading the Grizz to the victory in North Dakota.
Definitely, AJ. I think that Shea smithwick-hann really is a luxury as a backup quarterback, as a fifth-year senior. He's a very intelligent guy, and you have to give him credit. Most folks look at that game and they see the interception he threw late in the game that essentially got North Dakota back in it, but then he turns right around and hits Jamal Jones on the long bomb that set up the winning field goal. A lot of composure there, I thought.
Big pass play allowed them to pull out the 18-15 victory last week on the road, and so he is there just in case they need him if Jordan Johnson isn't ready to go another week down the road when the Grizz host UC Davis. But who else is really needing this week to get a little healthy before the next action?
Well, I would say Trayvon Vann is definitely interesting. He's had bumps and bruises. He didn't play a lot of the second half against North Dakota with an elbow issue, elbow and shoulder issue.
Banged up all around, really.
Right, yeah. Right. He was in good spirits in practice this week, and I think he'll be back. You think about Mike Ralston, their best blocking tight end.
Right.
I think it's important to get him back. I think they struggled without him against North Dakota, their run game. And so it'll be nice to get him back. And Justin Whitted, this strong safety, should be back for their next game. He's an important part of that really good defense.
Right, and either way, it'll be really nice to have some of those guys who are maybe playing a little closer to 100% than they have in the last few weeks. As the Grizzlies try to move to 3-0 down the road here against UC Davis, and Bill, they are 2-0 in conference here and have really survived some tough early season tests. Where do you see this Grizzly team at right now, about the midway point of the season?
I think they're sitting really good, AJ. I mean, they've got their toughest games ahead of them, toughest tests defensively ahead of them for sure, with Eastern Washington and Sac State and Montana State.
Right.
We're going to see just how good that defense is. But to be 2-0 right now, the defense is playing well. The offense is coming together, with the exception of the running game. They're going to need more of a running game if they want to be conference champs. And I think that's within the realm of possibility.
Yeah, and they'll get those teams a little bit later down the road. That UC Davis game will be next Saturday at home at Washington Grizzly Stadium. But football fans can get a look at the Aggies ahead of time, because they are going to be playing the Cats this weekend. Maybe a little bit of a preview. I bet all the Grizzly players and coaching staff will be watching that game as well.
Definitely. It's on at 5 o'clock. It should be on television here in Missoula. And it's interesting from the standpoint, Montana State will be making their second trip in as many weeks to California.
Right.
So that's a lot of traveling.
Right after that shootout they had with Sac State last week.
Yeah. And on the other hand, UC Davis has really struggled. They're 1-4. And they're banged up, so I look for Montana State to win that game, but it will be fun to see those two future opponents play each other.
Yeah, and again, no game this week for the Grizzlies on the bye, but stick with the Mazzoulian to get all your Grizzly updates in print and online at Mazzoulian.com. And stay tuned for all of our videos weekly. Grizz Tracks going up every Thursday night to give you the latest on all Montana Grizzly football. Thanks for tuning in this week.